Welcome back to Let's Play Disco Elysium Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. I think this is the pawn shop. We need to go here because I remember why. We need to get a tape player, a reel-to-reel tape player. The armor pieces, yeah, it took a while. I'm just looking over this stuff. Yeah. Hardy, from the Hardy Boys, gave you a recording where the hanged man supposedly testifies to his intent to rape and pillage. Have a listen on a playback device, either in your room or find one from a pawn shop. Okay, the one in the room is broken. Unless we have an option at some point to fix it. And for some reason it's called the Doorgunner Megamix. When Kim's not around, ask Classie about Sunday night. So that would be shortly, because it's kind of getting late, isn't it? Ask for that later, too. This guy is across the thing. Tomorrow, when the, they call it the water? The water, whatever? The water gate? I'm not sure. After 9 to see if anyone's home, but her husband's across the way. So once they close what we here in the States call a drawbridge, we can go across. There's something she wants to tell you. Joyce's info. Oh, yeah. We need the badge, or do her a favor. The water lock. Alright. Close the water lock. Yeah, Wednesday. We're on Tuesday now. Replace this wherever we can. Buy pants for him. Have enough money for that? Not sure where we can buy it anyway. Who else has unauthorized access to the whirling trash? May take a while. Probably no one we can talk to right now. Or would tell us. Access the harbor. Yeah, we can't get through. What's the guy's name? Measurehead. And tattoos, ask around. The boots. Good to take the body down first. Call us Alice back in a day. I guess that hasn't happened yet. And find the secret passage. Oh, we have more. Track down gun, badge, and sing karaoke. We have to get a tape to do that. Alright, so is this the place? I think it is. It is. Hi.
Hello again. How can I help you?
I'm looking for something that plays a tape. It's for police business. Yeah, we still have these boom boxes on the shelves. I can't figure out if, he's high. What's about the missing gun again? Sure thing. Never mind. Is something I like to sell? I'm not giving in the photo. Sell my clothes. How do we get into access your pawn menu? I seen this? This crumpled up postcard depicts an open air market in Boogie Street 5 years ago, or about 5 years ago. A vendor smiles as dead roosters line his stalls. Hung by their feet from canopy, red blood flows onto the muddy street. Blurry shadows of people pass. I'm kind of wondering if we might need this stuff for something else. I'm not going to sell his pen. Boxes. Do I just... Oh, these. The boomboxes wait on the shelves, and your boombox, that golden amber Harmon Wowshi, stares at you longingly with its tape-reel eyes. Huh. So, it's interesting. I thought I was going to have to go into, you know, a list of vendor stuff, which is most games would, you know, bring you up a list of things to buy and sell, and it's just not that way. Which is cool. Can I just play a tape on one of the boomboxes real quick? Sorry, man. I can't be giving out freebies. Never have. Won't now. Can I get a discount on this boombox? A police discount. A discount? I do have to keep the lights on, man. It's 12 real. Conceptualization says, remember, he doesn't like music, he likes sounds. The Doorgunner Megamix is his kind of tape. Certainly he'd give you a discount if he knew you'd play something so experimental. I love you, Conceptualization, right now. How much money do I... I can do that. I'm not just doing any police work. I've got the Doorgunner Megamix here. An era-defining work. Let's do 4 real. He purses his lips. 4 real is offensively low, but just this once. For the musique concrete cop. This is almost all my money anyway. Thanks for the discount, man. Here's the money for the boombox. And here you go. Quality sound reproduction on the go. It'll play anything, wherever. Turn any tape into a conversation of sounds and shapes. Yeah, whatever you say. So, it's a tool. This is the reel-to-reel boombox of everyone's youth. A little banged up, a little chipped, and honestly, not that loud either. Looks cool though. Excels at being carried on the shoulder, allowing you to pay audio tape items and blast music into the face of unsuspecting strangers. Sweet. I think we should go back to the room. The hotel room. Before we play this tape. Revachol? I thought it was Revachol. It was Revachol. I guess that's what I'm playing now on the tape player. We can't call her yet. What time is it? It's late. Have you heard back from the ICP about the serial number? Yes, the armor was produced by, she looks at her notes, Fairweather in their facilities in Betancourt, Sur La Clef in 42. It was part of a special order for Corps de Pharmacie, a security firm contracted to protect the interests of Aranier's pharmaceutical companies in the Seminine district, in the Seminine conflict, sorry. All right, cool. I didn't think we could do this yet. So we're still looking about these boots. She browses pages. So it seems the armor, or the armor rather, right, the boots is another thing. So it seems the armor went to Seminine. That's where the paper trail ends, though. Even the firm has proven difficult to track. Corps de Pharmacie has been renamed several times over in the years since the armor was issued. Do you know what it's called now? The most recently registered firm that the ICP has been able to connect to the CDP is a military contractor called Krennel, and the one before it was Downwell. I think they might be the same contractor. Visual Calculus says, a suit of armor like this would have been manufactured with a particular person's physique in mind. You should ask for whom this suit was fitted. A suit of armor like this would have been customized to fit the wearer. There must be a record of the person to whom it was issued. Yes, but the ICP tends to be reluctant to share private sector records. I could try to talk them into it, though. Esprit de Corps says, this is a fun challenge for her, an opportunity to contribute beyond doing her job by rote. She'll gladly put in the extra effort for Team RCM. Yes, thank you, officer. I really appreciate your efforts in this case. Glad to help. Call back tomorrow. Hopefully I'll have more for you then. Did you find out more about the owner of the armored boots? Not yet, but I was able to convince the database people to share private sector information. They promised to get back to me by tomorrow morning. Do you have any other questions? Okay, I'm done that for now then. 57th, over and out. A voice disappears into void. Okay, so now, call Alice back in a day for info on the armor's owner. Alright. It's after 9 p.m. or not long after. By 2 a.m. everyone's asleep. Alright. I'm running around with this boombox blasting. I don't know what kind of music I'm playing. Oh wait, what happened? I got a thing. A thingy. I missed it. Wait. This feels right. You belong here. Oh, meaning for the karaoke? Yeah, I just need a cassette to sing along to, though. Let's have a listen to this. Alright, so what do? I've got it in my hand. Interact. The porta reel is just what you need. The reel's attached to the apparatus with a satisfying click. The tape is routed behind the magnetic reader. Play the tape. Wow. You push commencer, I guess it means play, and the tape starts spinning. Violent static and machine sounds fill the air. This isn't Revachol, a man's voice says. This is a village. I can almost see the elephants. Another loud screech, some kind of machine. Machinery. The harbor. Kim takes out his notebook. That's the sound of a calson crane? More static. When this crap is done, I'm gonna tear that place up. Soldier of Apocalypse style. Kill stuff. Dogs and chickens, too. Gonna rent a room, Cordy. A real nice one. This port is unintelligible. I don't give a crap. I'm done. I'm done mentally. I'll do them all in. Rape that disco whore on the counter. You know, the dancer whore upstairs. Do it Kohoi style. Never get that taste out of my mouth. A click, then silence. The rest of the tape is empty. The lieutenant passes the button marked Eritrea on your portareal. The tape stops spinning. What do you think? It seemed authentic enough. Probably recorded off their shortwave, then edited to seem more incriminating. He sounded like he was on patrol around the harbor walls. But he did say he's going to do it. You can't edit words into someone's mouth. Indeed, but... The lieutenant looks at the tape. You're familiar with this look now. It's his look of suspicion. Esprit de Corps says there's more going on here than we know. Who's this Cordy? One of the other mercenaries, I think. The one he was talking to. A friend of his? What's Kohoi? A village on the Samaran Asola in South Sefray. Grad committed war crimes there. The kind of things he talks about. You think he was there? Who knows? Maybe the tattoos would have an answer. Or maybe Kohoi is just merc talk for atrocity. Slaughter. Rhetoric says a symbol of soldier of apocalypse style conduct in a civil environment. What was that at the very end? Silence? End of recording. Okay then, what now? I think we've got a few more questions for Classier, don't you? He looks around. This seems to contradict her testimony, at least to some degree. As you take out the tape, the boombox tunes itself back to the cheery radio again, spewing out beats like it's a Friday night. Empathy says, the contrast feels chilly. Inappropriate, even. Alright, well, I'm gonna put my little baggie back in. I had an option to sell him my clothes. I guess that's the clothes I'm not currently wearing. What about the guy in the... what do you call it? A pawn shop. I guess we're talking to Classier again, twice, because we gotta talk to her again when Kim's not around. I don't know when Kim plans on calling it at night, probably 9 o'clock. Don't be afraid to say weird things. People are more forgiving to persons of power, like police officers. Yeah, drugs are generally bad for your health. Talk to Classier about the Doorgunner Megamix, yep.
Officer, what brings you up here in the rain?
She leans back against a railing. Titus Hardy gave us a recording where the deceased states his intention to commit rape. She puts her coffee cup down. Did he? A smile flits across her face. I never said he was a good man, or that he had good intentions, only that he was never bad to me. Rhetoric says she doesn't care. If anything, she sounds amused. On this tape, he specifically identifies you as the target. Where did they get this recording exactly? Kim says, it's intercepted radio chatter of the deceased, recorded via de-encryption station. It's authentic enough. She arches her brow. Does he say he's going to do it soldier of the apocalypse style? Those are... I'm pretty sure, yeah, those are the exact words he used. Yeah, that was practically his pickup line. She picks the cup back up. Did he say whores a lot? Was he pretty much on the verge of doing it Kohoi style? Kohoi was mentioned. He wasn't actually there. He didn't do a tour, or at least didn't tell me he did. Would have been overkill anyway. He lived his own little Kohoi. It was in his... everything. Why say things like that? Machismo? Kim says yes. Was he bragging? Oh no, I'm pretty sure he did all those things, then integrated them into his idea of normalcy. To keep on living, until they just sort of turned into his, she thinks. What's the word I'm looking for? Persona? Running joke. I was going to say running joke. That wasn't even one of the options, I don't think. And it sounds like you didn't even get the good bits. Lely's punchlines got way, way funkier than that. He was like the Seminese conflict, the Kohoi massacre, and the 36 famine in Yisut all rolled into one person, then cast in Aranier ceramic armor, which he wore in bed and in the shower. You like this kind of stuff? We're all scraping up any happiness we can find, officer. Going around with our little scouring sticks. You, your first love, Mr. Kohoi here. Kim asked, did he tell you he had actually done any of those things? He and Martinez, I mean? No. We were too busy laying waste our own nervous systems to direct any of the fury outward. He seemed, she thinks, he seemed happy, I guess, at ease. As much as any man like him could be. Logic says, what kind of man was he? Before you go, ask for details. She seems okay to talk about it. Thanks, Logic. Thank you for clearing that up, miss. Kim talks. Kim turns to you. Whenever you're ready, I'm interested in hearing what Titus Hardy has to say now. We're not leaving yet. We got details. She takes a very small sip of her coffee and smiles. Now that you've had some time, can you tell us more about the victim? Kim says, like, for example, his name? Was his name Lely or something? Actually, officer, I didn't know his name. I just called him Lely. Okay, so does she know Lely was not his name? A nickname? Kim asked. I guess. He came from Lelystad. It's short for that. And it was his army name, apparently. He said his real name wasn't his. I tried to pry it out of him, but it was no use. Lelystad. That's a good start. The lieutenant writes it down in his notebook, then starts tearing out a page, but stops mid-motion. It just occurred to me, colleague, he says, turning to you, we still haven't performed a field autopsy on the deceased. Yeah, 'cause we haven't gotten him down yet, Kim. The questions I have assume some kind of foreknowledge on our part. I suggest we go and perform it now and return once we brought ourselves up to date. I have other questions first. All right, but quickly. She has endured that sight long enough. He nods toward the yard. It's time for us to do our duty. Well, don't we have to get him down to do a field autopsy? The old woman nods in silent approval, then feeds herself another cigarette. No, this is... I don't have anything else. Let's talk more about this so-called assault. Not my favorite topic, she flicks the ash away, but okay. No, it seems like we all... Never mind. Let me talk to you about your room again. What does that door lead to? Pointing to the door on the roof. You tell me, officer, when you've kicked it down. I'm wondering myself, but I'm light of foot. Not a good door kicker. All right, we'll turn to this later, miss. Is this very low? Okay, never mind. So I could talk to Titus. I think we're going to do that. Then we're going to do a field autopsy on this guy without taking him down? Because we couldn't take him down.
The clowns are still hanging around. What is it now?
So I talked to Classier about the tape. And? And nothing. She stands by what she said. He stares at his beer for 2 seconds, intently, then turns to you. You're the worst cops in Revachol. I gave you gold on that tape. Rhetoric says, the curse wasn't aimed at you, it was at her. It was dark stuff, but it didn't prove anything, and it didn't change her mind. Dark? Dark is when you start a goddamn death rock band. He said he'd rape her. He shakes his head in disbelief. What did she have to say then? Fine by her? This is what people are supposed to be like? Whoop-de-doo. She did not say whoop-de-doo. Kim says, I can confirm that. Esprit de Corps says, I see what you're doing here. Let's push him. Okay. She didn't? Well, whoop-de-doo then. He's too angry to drink his beer. He just stares at it. What's pushing him? If anything, she seemed turned on by the whole door gunning thing. Yes, Kim says. In fact, the lieutenant looks at you, then him. I think she thought it was a little funny. Funny? Titus mumbles, his lips barely moving. No, good goddamn psycho whore. Logic says, seems like they wanted to give Classier a second chance to play along. She still didn't. All right. He slams his giant fist on the door frame. All righty then. I guess it's good then. That. Elizabeth says, please try to control yourself in the presence of visitors, Titus. Her voice is a bit softer than earlier. Titus rubs his chin with his palm, as if trying to grind it smooth. It's just perfect. Just perfect. Any thoughts on this, lawman? Rhetoric says, you don't have to say everything out loud. Just mix and match. You don't have to say everything out loud. All right. Mix and match. Is it literally telling me I don't have to pick all these? Maybe she isn't who you thought she was. Nah, I know her. He looks upstairs, distracted. She's just a girl in over her head. She's not some helpless girl. She handled the mercenary well enough. Handled him? He balks. She got into some stupid crap with that guy. Crap we had to take care of. Kim says, yes, yes, we heard all about it, and the fact still stands, you were more disturbed by the tape than her. I think you had a lie planned, but she didn't play along. I asked you for an opinion, not a bedtime story. Tell it to your grandma. This tape was the last chance for her to do what was planned. But she didn't, Kim says. She knows she can't lie to us, unlike you. Fantastic. So now you remember how to do your job. He despondently glances at his beer. I'm so sick of this piss. We should get something harder in here. Shanky says, yeah, guys, we should get a party going tonight. Theo says, why? Shanky says, he looks at the old man in the corner. Maybe not then. Logic says success. They admitted to unlawful collaboration to derail the investigation. Be straight with me, Titus. What really happened? I already told you. He puts his giant face in his hands and sighs. We hanged him. Empathy says there's less gusto in his voice now. His men, too, are growing increasingly silent. Kim says, come on, Titus, it's been a long day. I'm tired of running back and forth between you. I can see you're tired, too. Why don't you just... You know what? He gets closer. I am tired. I'm tired of you and the whore upstairs. Next time you see her, tell her Titus said, beep. He throws his beer can down. That lying, scamming... We're done. This is over. You understand? Your little investigation is over. Alan says, yeah. There's a silence in the room. Alan starts saying something, then thinks best not to. What's this quiet funeral crap? What we need is some beers in us. Looks around. Bartender, 20 beers for the Dock Workers Union. Guard says, why don't we make it 40, huh? The man shouts from behind the counter. Why don't we make it 100 beers? You're not loud enough. Glenn says, 100 beers? Now we're talking. Glenn livens up. Hoppity hop over here, cafeteria manager. Should we try this? Rhetoric. Oh, minus one for push Titus on the tape. Plus one for discuss the eighth Hardy. Alright, try to convince Titus he's being manipulated. Damn. Classier is playing them like a fiddle. Rhetoric failing, though. Tell them how bad they got it played and they'll tell you the truth. There are many ways to go about it. All of them really good. Alright, well, rhetoric failed, so whatever we're going to do here is going to fail. I guess how entertaining do we want to fail? So in other words, tell them how bad they got played and they won't tell me the truth. Because rhetoric doesn't know what's going on in this case. I'm not going to get Gart involved in all this. I'm not going to embarrass Kim either. Nor am I going to ask him for his gun. I'm afraid if I go this angle, I'll get punched. I know what's going on here. I've been wrong, too. I got this dark shadow over my heart. What the hell are you talking about? As I awakened to this world, something came with me, an ancient sadness. Oh, that shadow. A man your age. The hangover must be lethal. He measures you up. Never thought I'd say this, but maybe you should cut back on the drink? Kim says, that's enough for the shadow now, officer. Let's do procedural questions, or even... He nods towards the exit. Why not take a little breather? Damage morale. These working-class oafs don't know how to talk about feelings. You should have opened up to... You shouldn't have opened up to them or anyone. Alright. Can't convince him until I put more in that. I gotta take off now. We need help with this. So can we do that? A field autopsy? I guess we'll try that next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. Actually, I need to take a look at this. Hardy and the boys know the whole story. It'll be difficult to get it out of him. Have you thoroughly inspected the body? Looked around for a witness? Gotten friendly with the union boss and the company rep? Really gotten a class J? I have to wait for Kim to leave. Convince Hardy boys to tell the whole story, and then question class J about the dead man. Class J told you she can't talk about him now, but you need specifics, height, build, etc. to confirm your autopsy. Ask her a little later when she's collected herself. Return to Class A after doing the autopsy. Ask her again about the hanged man. Alright, that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.